Hallo, heute sind wir im Globopark.
Generally, if you think about how far the pregnancy, we're getting towards the end. But as we have very little experience with the total number of killer whales that have ever been pregnant and that we followed up, so there would be like 24, 26, something around this number. We have a database, but it's very limited. So we believe that the total gestation time for a killer whale is 17 and a half months, plus minus 2 months. So we have the exact day that she ovulated, and if we calculated those 17 and a half months, that would be for the 20th of September. But then we would put a plus minus 2 months before and 2 months after, because some killer whales had their babies at 15 and a half months, and some killer whales had their babies at 19 and a half. So she's entering within what we believe is the month of birth. We have a lot of other controls to try to narrow down the date. We are taking her temperature twice a day. We are taking the measurements of her mammary glands. We are doing ultrasound. We are checking if she's having contraction. We are checking how much she defecates, how the way she swims has changed, and so on. So there's a lot of other factors that help us assess if we're getting nearer the date. Talk about Morgan and ultrasound. So we have the chance here that it was possible to train a lot of the trainers to do the ultrasound, and they are sending the images over so we can check it. And people would be curious, what are we checking when we do this? So we're trying to see the position of the baby, to know what's the position. And we know that, you know, she's carrying more on the left side, the head is at that level of the body, the baby is bent. And every day we can see the head of the baby, the orbit, we can see the rostrum, we can see the neck, we can see the front part of the thorax, if we're lucky, but recently it's been a lot, we can see the heart rate. And now we have generally a heart rate for the baby that's about 60 per minute. But sometimes when the baby's a bit excited or something happens, we have that heart rate going up to 70 or 80. And then the animal can go on the other position, so we can look on the other side. The baby is bending down, and on the other side of the body we can see the end of the body, that's called the peduncle, and we can see the fluke. And it's really the center that we can't see, because the machine allows us to see to a depth of 30. So at the beginning we would see the fetus in its entirety, I mean completely, and now we're following it every day, and so we can see. So the baby's like in a C position. Generally they're born with the tail first, and we're trying to see. It's not that the baby is moving before the birth, but that C is going to change a little bit. And we're trying to identify, like a day or two before the birth, if the head is getting more to the genital area or maybe the tail, so that we could maybe say it's going to be a head first or a tail first. It's very difficult, you know, only 24, 25 killer whales, but we're using our expertise in dolphins to do this, and we'll see. But we're trying to see if there's any change in the position of the baby lately. So really using the technology available to us nowadays to learn more about this pregnancy in a killer whale.
One of the things that we need to talk about a little bit is also the social network and the social bonding and the family aspects of these type of animals. They're very connected, they have their own way to communicate, and the socialization is important. Not only is that, the reproductive sustainability is important, because the next generation of animals, we learn more from. And when a whale like Morgan comes into a beach and is dying, we have the ability to save that animal's life because of what we've learned with the animals here in our care. So that's very important. And it's very important to let these animals socially breed to the right genetics and the right mate. So it's important for sustainability again. It's in part of their welfare also. It would be very cruel not to let them procreate or breed. That's not the right thing to do. It's their choice. So this is important. So breeding with these animals is something that we do and we manage, but it's something we should let them do. And it's more about what we learn also to help future animals, especially an animal that's a young animal on the beach like Morgan.
Wenn ihr jetzt noch Fragen habt, schreibt sie in die Kommentare. Und wenn euch das Video gefallen hat, dann würde ich mich über ein Like sehr freuen. Damit ihr kein Video mehr verpasst, könnt ihr unseren Kanal kostenlos abonnieren.